Good morning, friends, and welcome to today's market commentary. So on daily time frame chart, what we can witness is that Nifty is facing a heavy resistance on the upside and it is trying to be bullish, but something is stopping it from being bullish. Now let us mark our previous resistance zones, which we tried to mark in our earlier market commentary. So on the upside, this gap is a strong resistance to Nifty. Now below that we have one more resistance, which is nothing but the high of this bearish engulfing candle. So 10,710 is the next level of resistance for Nifty. So Nifty is facing two resistances on the upside. Now if you see the RSI also, it is in between 40 to 60, which is a sideways zone. Yes, of course, Nifty is trying to break its previous resistances every time. Since the time it made a low of 10,000, it is trying to take a U-turn and it is also trying to be bullish. But the problem here is, as I always tell you, that until RSI is not trading above the 60 level, we cannot think of Nifty breaking its previous highs. So if it is trading above 40, then we can search for bullish opportunities. But for Nifty to remove all the resistances on the upside, it needs to come up above the level of 60. So the live example you can see here itself. Whenever Nifty traded above the level of 60, Nifty's RSI, starting from this 9th July to 3rd of September, if you see, all these days RSI of Nifty was above 60, and you can see from the closing price of 10,852, it made a high of 10,800. So around 1,000 points of upward movement we could see in Nifty. The reason was just that Nifty's RSI value was trading above 60. So in order for Nifty to make highs, higher highs every day, the value of RSI should be above 60. So as of now, what we can just search on the chart is, so there are two probabilities here. Either Nifty might break this value of 60 and go above, and even the price also might break this resistance and go above. That is one probability here. And the second probability is that Nifty's RSI value might face a resistance at 60, and even the price level of Nifty also might face a resistance near this 10,700 to 10,800. So Nifty might come up, it might face a resistance, and again it might go back. So whatever the upward movement that it has to give, it is already given. The high made until now is around 10,645. So since the time it made a low of 10,004, where we could observe a bullish divergence, the Nifty, the index, moved up by around 600 points. So that's also a bullish journey. So now there's no reason left for Nifty to be bullish. That is the main point here. So the result season also is about to complete, and elections coming up in several states. So today one state is having election. So the outcome would definitely depend on whether the government is going to be stable or not, or whether the reformations that have already taken place, will they be in the place, or will the new government come and take out them? So there are several factors that the index will take into consideration in its bullish journey. But as of now, there's no reason left for the indices to be bullish. So the conclusion from our discussion would be, this zone will act as a heavy resistance for Nifty. And if we enable the pivot points, so this is somewhere in between the pivot point, so central pivot point and R1. So all the resistances are within this zone only. So there we are not getting any clear picture. So we can only depend on this resistance and the value of RSI. If RSI goes above 60, then well and good. So Nifty has a probability of breaking these resistances and a new upward journey. And if Nifty faces a resistance near the value of 60, and the price of Nifty also, if it faces a resistance near 10,700, then definitely a U-turn on the downside can be seen in Nifty. So even in Bank Nifty, the same story. The area where we could see a bearish engulfing pattern, these two candlesticks, if you see this red candle, it covered the complete, it covered the body of this green candle completely. So these two candlesticks combined together, we call it as bearish engulfing candlestick. And the high of that day was 25915 and today it is 25907. So even Bank Nifty is also facing a resistance there. And if you see the value of RSI, even in Bank Nifty also, it did not cross the value of 60 yet. So these are also points to be discussed. Now the area of resistance for Bank Nifty would be 25915 to 26065. Why this 26065 is a resistance in Bank Nifty? Because this was the first time when Bank Nifty took support there, second time and third time. So this was a support zone earlier. When that support zone got broken by this large red candle, that will now act as a resistance. And as I told you earlier, this is also a double bottom pattern. So it all depends now whether Bank Nifty will face a resistance there and come back, or if it will break that along with RSI going above 60. So it's at both the indices are at a proper junction now. So they might go up or they might take a U-turn. The situation is like that. So we need to wait patiently for a proper breakout to be bullish, and we need to wait patiently for a bearish candlestick pattern at this resistance to be bearish on both the indices. Now coming to our stock picks for the day, UBL worked out well. That was a small resistance on the upside, or I can say it's a small flag pattern here. So this is the pole of the flag and this is the flag itself. So today's low, it took support near this lower trend line support, and from there it started to bounce back. It almost gave 2% in intraday itself, and it is still finding its way on the upside. Now where did it find the resistance? Prior swing high 1287, and today's high is also 1287.2. So there it found a resistance, and in case if it breaks that 1287 price level, if it gives a good close above that, then that's going to be a good bullish journey for UBL on the upside. Even M&M Financial Services also, this was the prior swing high, and if we connect it with this high, we get a trend line resistance there. Even this this stock also faced resistance near prior high. So if the stock goes above and trades above this prior high, the price level there is 439. So above 439, M&M Financial Services is bullish until 460, and above 460 it can straight away shoot up to 495. Kotak Bank last 3 days high, if you observe, high of 6th November, 7th November and 9th November, all these three highs are same. So today the low of the candle, it matches with the high of previous three candles, and starting from the day itself, it tried to be bullish. The only resistance, probable resistance that it might face is around this gap zone. So if this gap zone is taken out, immediately it will jump to 1195. So Hindustan Unilever is having a common high here, 1679. So, or to be precise, it can be taken as 1680. So above 1680, Hindustan Unilever is bullish until 1791. So around 110 rupees of movement can be seen on the upside if HUL settles above this price level of 1680. Even in BEML, we have a common high here, 733.5 and 733.45. So above 733.5, if this stock settles, now that is a prior support as well. See here, first time and second time, price took support there and it faced a resistance all these days. So if price settles above 735, it will be a start of new bullish journey. Now see the double bottom chart pattern here. When the neckline was broken from 640, the price gave an upward movement of around 100 rupees. That there was also a bullish divergence here. So on the other day, someone was asking, in a double bottom chart pattern, shouldn't the lower bottom be higher than the first bottom? It's not always, because we always take this RSI divergence into consideration. So price was making a new low here and RSI was making a higher low. So that's a bullish divergence there. And here we had the neckline of the pattern. So when this neckline got broken, this bullish divergence came into act and then the bullish rally also started. Now if we take the help of these pivot points also, so when this neckline got broken, the price was in bullish zone. As far as all the indicators are concerned, price was in bullish zone. RSI was above 60 and price was above 20 SMA and central pivot point. So this is the accuracy of three things, or three or more things combined together in order to find bullish opportunities. Now let's take the stocks from participant side. Yes, even in Maruti, we have a chance coming up. Let's evaluate that. Definitely, this is also a double bottom pattern. And even in Maruti, we have a bullish divergence. Price making lower low and RSI making a higher low. So there's a double bottom chart pattern and RSI bullish divergence. Now let's check the zone of price, bullish or bearish. Price is above central pivot point bullish. So completely the stock is in bullish zone. Currently the value of RSI is around 50. So if the value of RSI comes above 60 and if the stock breaks this neckline, that will be a huge up rally for Maruti on the upside. So in order to strengthen our view, let's go to option chain and see what is the resistance for Maruti on the upside. So the highest OI lies at 7500 for this month and current price is 7200. So yes, definitely there is a large upside of 300 points left for Maruti on the upside. And after that, if 7500 is taken out, the next level of resistance is at 8000. So definitely keep this stock in your watch list. If the price level of 7350 is taken out, that means the candle should close above that and RSI also should trade above 60. Just blindly go long on this stock because all the factors are on the bull side. Even in Yes Bank, we have double bottom chart pattern, but the neckline is so confusing here. So what we can do is we can shift to line chart here, and this becomes the neckline. So the price level of neckline is 251.4. So now neckline is confirmed. This is a double bottom chart pattern. So our aim should be that RSI should come above 60. That is first thing. Then pivot points. It's already in bullish zone. Bollinger Bands is already in bullish zone. So let this neckline get broken and let this value of RSI come above the value of 60. Highest OI lies at 230. So the neckline itself might not the neckline, but the prior gap down zone. Let me zoom in a bit. Yes, this is the reason the stock is facing a resistance now. First of all, there's a prior gap down. And if you see that gap zone, the upper resistance is 230. And Yes Bank, where is the highest OI built up? Call option 230. So that is the reason 230 is acting as a strong resistance to Yes Bank. So this double bottom chart pattern might not get activated in the near future. It's better to shift to any other stock. State Bank, it's in the middle of its journey. Cannot say anything as of now because it seems to have taken a U-turn already. Even Bajaj Finance, it is in sideways zone as of now. So no clear movement in the stock. Yeah, LIC Housing Finance, definitely this is a double bottom chart pattern. So now this trend line resistance is of no use now. All we have to concentrate is on this neckline. So the neckline is 450, 4.05. Now the value of RSI should come above 60 and price also should close above 454.05. Price is already in bullish zone, so no worries there. Highest OI in LIC Housing Finance is built up at 450. And the neckline for us is 454.05. So yes, definitely if this 454.05, this if this level is taken out, all these option sellers will have to close their positions, which will force this stock to be super bullish. Now 454.05, that is actually the prior support level. Here if you see, stock took support there. So now it will definitely act as a strong resistance. So let the value of RSI come above 60 and let the stock close above 454. Definitely it is going to be a super bullish. So TVS Motor is actually bearish as of now. Because the highest call option OI lies at 560 and there is also a long term trend line resistance there. There is also now a horizontal resistance being built up at 565. So too many resistances on the upside. Even the value of RSI is also not that bullish at the border of 51. So definitely that's a U-turn happening on the bearish side. But the other factors, it is saying that price is in bullish zone, but definitely as of now, as per my view, it is taking a U-turn and it is trying to be bearish now. Start of bearish journey, I can say. Yeah, so none of the candle closed above 0.618 level here. Yes, too many confirmations on the bearish side. So be careful in going long on the stock because most of the factors are indicating bearishness. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.